salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more, or whispers of are you sure. Never have I ever before, but I can see us lost in the memory. I get slipped away into a moment in time, cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bedsheets. I get slipped away like a bottle of wine, cause you were never mine.
Hello and welcome to a new episode of my podcast called Knit Dreams, Wool and Love. Today's episode is called The Journey, and today's episode will be a bit like unplugged because I want to tell you my story. So the journey is my personal journey, and to tell you about my story and the background for my knitting trips. That is really important to me because my knitting trips to New Zealand and to Ireland, or hopefully more knitting trips to come, is not just a holiday where I did a visit at a yarn shop and then bought some yarn and thought I could tell you about that. My knitting trips is a part of a big dream, a life passion of being creative and to create a life with passion and joy. So it's really important for me to tell you that story. And I think it's also important for you, because then when I tell you in another episode about my knitting trip to New Zealand and to Ireland, it will make more sense. Like it will, I think it will give some more meaning into it. So yes. And yes, before I start, I will tell you that I have decided that my episodes have names instead of numbers, because many of the my podcast episodes is about my knitting design, where I make a episode about each knitting design, because in almost every design there is a story about where I found the yarn, or what I had experiences. And I put some adventure in every pattern I make. And therefore, if you want to knit the scrap vest or the scrappy cardi, it would be really annoying if you don't remember if it's episode number 2 or number 10. Then it's much easier, and it's smart, I think, that you can say, I want to knit the scrappy cardi, and then you find the episode about that. So that's why it's called names. Yes, but first, before I go into my story, I will introduce myself to you who haven't seen me before or been here into my podcast before. My name is Trine in Danish. I'm a Danish woman living in Denmark. I'm 56 and I live here all alone on a farm far away at the countryside in Denmark. I am a knitting designer. I am a lecturer. I'm an author. I am a coach, a teacher, a mom, a woman. Someone said to me years ago, you are an adventurer. And I just love that. I think, oh yes, I am. And I like adventures. And I am, how do you say, I actually have a bit of help here. Excuse me. Just a moment. It's because sometimes I don't remember the English words, so I have a bit of help here. Yeah, someone said to me not long ago, "Oh, Trine, you are a professional habit breaker." But that's quite right. I have habits. Of course, I have in routines, but I get curious and I like to go on adventures. Yes. So, yeah, let's get started. As I said, this will be a bit unplugged. I don't have, you know, notes or anything. I will do just tell you a story. And before I start, maybe I should say that it's a good idea to grab your needles and knit, or if you are ironing or in the garden or driving or something, you can put in your earplugs and listen, because I know it will be, I think this episode will take maybe, I don't know, 30 minutes or something like that. So, well, I have been knitting all my life. I've been knitting since before I got into school, because my mom was really she was really good at handcraft, or what to say, she could make the embroidery, she painted the porcelain, she was sewing and knitting and crochet and what do you call that, knipple? I don't know if that's a word in, I don't know, but she made these lace things with all these small sticks. Yeah, but she did a lot of, she was really good, and she was really accurate, you know, it was really, really, she was so skilled at doing these things. And so I was knitting before I got to school. I was knitting in school, as when I went to classes, I was knitting, you know, because I was such a good girl, and I was good at school, and and I was skilled, and I was quiet, so I could knit while I was in, when I had, you know, went to school. And when I was a teenager, I also did knit a lot of sweaters, even when I started going, you know, oh, how to say that in English, when I did, you know, going on a disco and went out party hardy, then I sew small skirts, you know, short skirts, and I knitted some sweaters with some glittering stuff in it, and the back, it was a deep V neckline, or what do we call that, you know. So it was just, knitting was a part of my life, even when I should be trendy. So and actually my dream was to get an education as a designer, but that wasn't quite easy here in Denmark, and it was like, it was different from, you know, it wasn't a traditional education, and no one did really, I feel like no one listened to me. And my parents and my teachers, they thought I was such a good girl and really skilled, you know, in school. So they should, they thought I should go to the, yeah, here it's called gymnasium. I think it's called high school. And I didn't want to, but I should, and I did. And it was hard for me. I did get my, in Denmark I got the education, I got the exam and everything, but it wasn't, I didn't want to study anything. Actually, when I was 19, back in, 1985, I said, I don't want to study. I don't want to live a 9-to-5 life. I want to go on adventure. I want to live off my, and I make the creative, you know, my creative skills, I want to make that as a living. But it was hard for me, and my friends, they just did like, well, you have to, you know, do have a 9-to-5 life. And it was just, why do I have to do that? But I did. And of course you have to earn some money for your living, or if you want to save money for a going on a to travel around the world and all that. So yes, it I got into it. I had to, and I got after some years I got an education as a teacher, but in specialized, you can say, in handcrafts. So I I am a teacher, you know, sewing, knitting on a machine, doing the print on fabrics and all kind of stuff. Back in 1992, I got that education. So it was a creative school I went to, and that was quite lovely. But then I had to, you know, find some jobs, and I went from job to job, and I had some creative jobs where I could use my education and my skills. But it was quite, it was not, I don't know, back then and here in Denmark, it's not the jobs, there are not many jobs like that. So, and then I met my love of my life, my husband, and we got children and house and cars and everything. And then we have to, you know, earn some money, and the real life just hit me. And there was nothing wrong with that. I have to say that I just loved my husband. I love my children. I love being a mom now and back then when they were, you know, babies and 2-3 years. I just loved it so, so much. So nothing wrong with that at all. And my he's now my ex-husband, but we went to New Zealand and Tonga and Thailand when Gustav was 1 year old, 1 year old, and Ophelia was 3, and we put on our we went on backpacking with those two small kids all around the world. That was so lovely. So we did stuff, but about my work, I wasn't satisfied, though I had some jobs that was quite creative. It wasn't enough for me. I was so, it was hard for me with this every day where I had to get up every morning at the same time to get my kids ready and get them and you know, give them away to the kindergarten, whatever it's called in English, you know. And it was so much against my heart and my energy. So it was so tough with me, and I was so much wanted to work with what I'm skilled for and passionate about, because I felt when I did something creative, I just got so happy and so passionate. And so it has been a thing for me all my life. I really tried. I had a shop with children's clothes where I make my own design. I tried a lot of stuff, made some designs for some magazines, and I really tried. And yeah, as I said before, since I was 19, I had this dream about I want to make this my living, so I could live of, you know, working with that on my own with all my ideas. During the years, there wasn't anything wrong with my husband or my kids or anything. I think I had something with me, you know, personal, and I had a really good childhood, caring, as with a lot of love. So I can't explain, and I won't, you know, do an episode of my childhood and all that. But I can't say that I have been it has been a good childhood, and I had a lovely husband and everything. So I can't explain why it was like that. But my self-worth was just going down and was disappearing. That was really awful. So, and in 2008, my mom passed away, and that was really tough for me. And in 2012, I got divorced, and that was even tougher. But it was like the drop. So it was not only the divorce, it was something that has, you know, has been on its way for many years. And I actually think I had a depression that hasn't been, you know, taken care of. So everything just crashed in my life in 2012, and that was totally awful. And I could tell you Yeah, I could make an episode about that, and I don't want to, because that was really just, was so sad, and I was crying like for years. It was awful. But lucky me, I have so many good people in my life, both family, friends. I had so many good colleagues, and I went to therapists and everything, and I actually got a education as a coach. And I could use that, you know, professional, but I could also use it personal. So I learned so much from that. So in 2016, I think I was on my way up. And in that process and on that way, I have I learned that that yes, I could say a lot of bad stuff about my boss and my colleagues and my job and my blah, everybody. But I have learned that if I want to make some changes, it has to be myself who take action. I can't just wait that others will do that. I'm the captain in my life. And if I want to make some any changes, I have to do it myself. So, and I will say my son and my daughter, I love them so much. And suddenly when, you know, on my way up, I got aware that I thought, no, I don't want to just, I'm not a mom for them. If I just cry, I want to show them that even though that life can be a bitch and you can be in a deep crisis, it's possible to get up and get on with life in a good way. And it's possible to use all the bad stuff in a good way because you learn so much about yourself. Oh, yeah. So actually in 2014, I went to New Zealand with my kids and we celebrated Christmas with my family out there. I have my brother and his family live in New Zealand. And, you know, back then, it was, I got aware of all the yarn and the wool in New Zealand and thought, wow, and it's, you know, I like when it's hot, I like the sun, I like to wear jandals, the flip-flops, I like warm, much more than cold, and here in Denmark, it's from like November to March, it's cold and, oh, it's not dark in March, but it's quite dark and cold and grey. And I'm not very fond of that. So in 2016, I felt much better. I was on the way up from the dark and I went up to life. And I felt all my old, like, creativity, my adventurous, you know, in my blood, that I want to travel, all my ideas, they came up to me. And then, as I said before, now I knew that if I wanted to do something, I had to do it myself. And then a idea came to me. Actually, my daughter went to New Zealand in 2015 and 16, and she is she has been at the Toi Whakaari school, whatever, in Wellington. So she is educated into the costume world. And through her, I also got a lot of inspiration from New Zealand. So in 2016, the idea came to me. I thought, wow, I could go to New Zealand when it's winter in Denmark, because then it's summer in New Zealand and I can travel around. Just immerse myself into knitting, buy wool and yarn produced in New Zealand and just knit what I want to. Because at home, when you have to go to work, you know, every day when I come home and then you have to whatever, cook and yeah, whatever you have to do. Then when I sat in my sofa to knit, I was just like falling asleep. So I could never get into this, you know, immerse myself, try new techniques or anything, follow my ideas. So I thought if I travel around New Zealand all by myself, then I could do that. And then the idea just grew and I thought I could make a book, and it's here. I could make a book where with patterns of my designs, for my designs, I could do, and I could write stories, talk to people, take pictures, and then make a book. My dream was to make a book that just makes happy, not a long story about New Zealand and the history, but a story about my experiences from New Zealand and a lot of joy and good vibes. That was my dream. So in 2017, January, I made a plan. I sat down and I made I tried to figure out if it was possible. Because when you are grown up and have all the expenses, I had an apartment, a car, and if I should save money to go on a trip like that, I was really, that was a challenge. But I sat down, I tried to figure out, what am I going to do? How do I want to do this? I didn't have anybody to look after. It was my idea. So I had to figure out for how long do I have to travel to have time enough for knitting and writing and all that. How will I get around? Where will I stay? How can I afford it? And you know, what will it cost? And can I do this? And in January 2017, I did that, and I made a decision that I wanted to try to do it. So I, all 2017, all the year, I used I worked hard. I was doing extra work. I was knitting like hats from all my scraps and sold them. I was serving at parties. You know, I was trying to earn money everywhere. And I also my budget, you know, my economy, my daily economy. I just, you know, I did like this. So I got out of all what I paid for, you know, it could be television or whatever. It was just out of that. So I had so as less expenses as possible. And I think in September I bought my ticket, and in November I realized that I didn't have money enough. So I went to the bank and said, please, I've bought the ticket. I want to make a book. I just so much want to go on this trip. It's my dream. And back then I had a really good bank, the person in the bank, you know, you talk to bank advisor, I don't know what it's called, but I think you know what I mean. She was just so cool and said, oh yes, that's cool. And then I got this, maybe you call it a credit, but so I could use money I didn't have. That was nice. So yes, I used all year to do these plans, and in January 2018, I think the 2nd of January, I went into the airport in Copenhagen, and then I just went off to New Zealand. But my New Zealand trip, I will tell you about that in another episode. My plan is to tell you about that trip, how I got around, what I did, experiences, which yarn companies I visited, and all that will be in another episode. But before I end this episode, I will tell you that it's not, I think it's a couple of weeks ago. Now I speak too fast and then I can't, sorry. I went for a walk here in this beautiful surroundings where I live. And when you walk, I feel a kind of peace. It's really, really healthy for me. And then I had some memories coming up, and that was from when I came home from my first knitting trip and went to work. I I had some, of course, chats with my colleagues, and I were telling them about my trip and how totally awesome the trip was to New Zealand, my first trip. And then I was telling about my dream, because I told them that my dream was to keep on doing these knitting trips. Then I wanted to write books about my knitting trips with these knitting patterns, and then I wanted to do lectures or talks, I don't know, I think it's the same, but about my trips, about the knitting, about living your dream, and, you know, doing these talks that could be inspiration to both knit and live. And it was really my dream. And then a colleague, a young guy, he looked at me and said, "Well, but you can't make that as a living." And I just said, oh, but I that's my plan. And back then, that's 5 years ago, back then I didn't knew what I was saying. But actually, that was a plan. That was my plan. And I didn't know how to do it. And it has been, these 5 years have been totally crazy and tough, but also totally amazing and fantastic. And now I sit here and I've done it and I into it, and I work all by myself here. And I've been, I've traveled like 2 times to New Zealand and 1 time to Ireland. And I am still have plans about going on knitting trips and continuing doing talks and continuing writing books and making designs and making this podcast. So it's magic when you dare to dream and when you dare to follow your dreams. Well, I hope that you can manage to listen to my Danish English. And I hope so much that you are curious to listen to more episode of my podcast, and I will tell you about my trips and my designs. And I think if you are listening, still are listening to me now, I succeeded, and I'm really happy that you do that. It would be a great place. It will be make me so happy if you will. It is called subscribing to this YouTube podcast, Knit Dreams, Wool and Love, because it can help me so much into my dreams. And yes, that's because, you know, I want to live up that. I so much want to write books, sell patterns and all that. But I really mean that from my heart, that I so much want to inspirate, to make send good vibes out there, joy and inspiration to you guys, so you can live your dreams, to make your dream make your life into an adventure, because that's possible if you want to. I know that. So thank you for listening. Thank you for staying. I hope to see you again out there. And my next episode will be about my trip to New Zealand. So stay tuned. See you out there. Bye-bye.
Salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more, or whispers of "Are you sure?" Never have I ever